So wait, to Skip a Lee. This is Mr. Davis, and we're going to look at the remains of the Roman Forum. Many people ask me about what does the Roman Forum look like today, and some of the structures and stuff that you saw in the wonderful video by Magister Kraft. So I'm going to go through some of the structures that he mentioned, and also a couple he didn't mention. So let's go ahead and start outside the classroom. So we're Colus Prope Conclave Latinum. So here we go. Eamus Discipuli Eamus. And here we go. We'll be using today a Google Earth, which is pretty cool. And so we can go ahead and jump into and see what it looks like today. So here is the Roman Forum and its glory today. So the Forum Romanum, Est spatium apertum in medio urbis Romae, ibi Romani antiqui poterant emere, vendere, versare apud amicos, loqui de republica, vel sacrificia facere. So the Forum Romanum is an open space in the middle of the city of Rome. There the ancient Romans were able to buy and sell, hang out with the friends, talk about the Republic, or make sacrifices. And here's a picture of what it looks like today. Pretty cool. All right, let's go to our first little area that we're going to take a look at. So we're looking here at the Via Sacra. So the Via Sacra, est clarissima via Romae, Via Sacra it ab Colosseum per Forum Romanum ad Capitolium Montem. Sunt multa templa et alia loca sacra prope viam sacram. So the Via Sacra is the most famous Roman road. Most famous road in Rome. The Via Sacra goes from the Colosseum through the Forum Romanum to the Capitoline Hill. There are many temples and other sacred space near the Via Sacra. So this is where you get the name. Okay, awesome. Next thing we're going to look here is the Arcus Titi. Hic Arcus Victorius Imperatoris Titi Memorat. So here, this arch commemorates the victories of the Emperor Titus. So one thing they like to put in the Roman Forum are, besides temples and governmental buildings and like places to buy stuff, they also like to put in monuments to commemorate great victories and emperors and so forth. And one of the most famous ones is the Arch of Titus here, which commemorates the Emperor Titus and his victories in the Middle East over ancient Israel and conquering the ancient city of Jerusalem. All right, one of the most famous but smallest temples is the Templum Vestae. Templum Vestae ignem sacrum Romae habebat, six virgines vestales ignem curebat. So the Temple of Vestae held the sacred fire in Rome. Six Vestal virgins took care of the fire. So it was the sacred spot where the eternal flame of the city was held. It was a circular building, kind of meant to be look like a hut. It's a very nice hut, would have columns of and marble and such, but it was supposed to be like kind of looking like a hut, and there'd be a fire that would be burning in there that the priestess of Vesta would take care of. All right, the next one we're going to is the Regia. Regia, of course, means palace in Latin. So in Regia, reges Romani habitabant et post reges sacerdotes hic conveniabant. So in the Regia, Roman kings used to live, and after the kings, priests would come together here. Some say the Pontifex Maximus lived here, so Julius Caesar, when he was Pontifex Maximus, would be living in this spot. This is right in the middle of the Forum, so it's a pretty cool place to be. Other thing to note is this little tile here is they found at the site, and you can make out the word Rex on it. We have an R, an EE, and looks like an X. So there we go, Rex. All right, let's look at the next one. All right, we have the Templum Divii Iulii. Hic post mortem Gaii Iulii Caesaris cives Romani corpus hic cremaverunt. Postea templum fecerunt. So here, after the death of Gaius Julius Caesar, the Roman citizens burned his body. Afterwards, they made a temple. So this was a temple to commemorate Julius Caesar. It doesn't look like much. It's just the front that's left. Let me show the pictures here so you can see it here. And if you look, and then here's the reconstructed view of it, looks, which looks a lot better. All right. Next one we're going to is the Basilica Aemilia. Hic Romani oratores causas dicebat et erat locus negotiae. So here, Roman orators used to plead cases, and it was a place of business. So it was a big, giant basilica, had open area in the middle of the building, and people could meet here, and then also law cases. So you can take a look here. Here's a picture of it today. Here's a reconstruction. Pretty nice. All right, next to the basilica, we have the Curia. Curia, hic erat locus senatus, senatores auxilium consiliumque debat regibus consulibus et imperatoribus. So here was the place of the Senate, where the Senate would meet. The senators would give help and advice to kings, consuls, and the emperors. So whoever is ruling Rome, they would go to the Senate for advice. Here's a picture of today. Here's the inside. And here's a picture that some artists have felt that kind of represents what it looked like on the inside back in the heyday. All right, next place we're going to is the Lapis Niger. Lapis Niger erat locus sacra ubi primum Romani suffragium feribat, etiam hic homines prima scripta verba Latinum invenerunt. So the Blackstone was a sacred space where first the Romans used to vote. Also here, the Romans or people found the first written Latin words. So it was a meeting place where people would get together to vote. So think of democracy. People were practicing a form of democracy here. And also underneath it, they found this, the first inscription of Latin ever found. People are still trying to decipher what it means. They've seen the word rex on this, but that's, and there's some other things written on it, but they're still trying to figure out exactly what it means. All right. All right, next thing I want to look here is Arcus Septimii Serui. Hic Arcus etiam victorias imperatoris memorat. Romani duo centum tres anno domini fecerunt. Duo centa. So here an arch also commemorates the victories of the emperor. This one is of the emperor Septimius Severus. And the Romans made this in 203 of the Common Era. So another big arch to commemorate victories. I'll give a little picture on this. You can see it. Pretty impressive. You might notice this. I also have a model of this in the Latin classroom. All right. Then we have the Umbilicus Urbis. Hic est medium Romae vocantur umbilicus sicut umbilicus corporis. So here's the middle, literally the middle of Rome. It's called the umbilicus, or the belly button, just like the belly button of the body. So it's the center of the city. All right, we have here the rostra. In hoc loco oratoris declamebant. Nomen venit ex rostris navium. All right, so the rostra the rostra here was a speaker's platform. So in this spot, speakers spoke. The name comes from the beaks of ships. So a rostra is the beak of a ship. So if you look at the front of this reconstruction of an ancient warship, on the front they have a ram that you can use to bash into other ships, and this is called a rostrum. And so when Romans created this speaker's platform, they pulled off the rostra off of various ships that were defeated in battle by the Romans and put it on the speaker's platform. And the speaker's platform then got its name from that. All right, carcer. Many people had a lot of questions about the carcer. So hic carcerum est. Romani viros malos et hostes Romorum in carcerum mittebat. So this is the prison. the Romans sent bad men and enemies of the Romans into this prison. So if you look at this, here's on the outside, and then you look underneath here, people would be put in here before they were punished by the Romans. So it was a holding cell, a prison for the city of Rome. All right, number 15 here. We're at Miliarum Aureum, ex hoc loco omnes via Romae eunt. So this is the golden milestone. So all the Roman roads from this spot, all the Roman roads go. And so the Romans considered this is the center where all the Roman roads met. All right, then we have the Temple of Saturn. Saturnus est pater Jovis, sub templo Saturni erat pecunium Romanorum. So this, so Saturn was the father of Jupiter. Under this temple of Saturn was the money of the Romans. So here's a picture of it today. Golden milestone would be out front. And here what it looks like, what people think they look like back in the day. And then the money would be underneath. All right. Then we have here the Basilica Julia. In Basilica Julia erat multa taberna et Romani publica consilia hic habet. Etiam in hoc loco dura dabantur. So in the Basilica, in the Julia Basilica, there were many shops, and the Romans also had public meetings here. Also in this place, laws were given. So again, it's a basilica where there are meetings and law courts. We'll show the pictures here a little bit. So here's what it looks like today. Here's a reconstruction. Quite different, huh? All right, last thing we're looking at. All right, last thing we got here is the Locus Curtius. Hic Locus Curtius est, said est locus sine aqua, sunt multa fabula de hoc loco, nemo verum fabulum scit. So this is the Locus Curtius, is a lake without water. There are many stories about this place. No one knows the true story. So here what it looks like today. Here's what it looked like back in the day. So there's some stories that a person who was fighting against Rome, an enemy champion, fell into the middle of the forum when there was a swamp here, and so it was called a locus, and it was named after him. In another story, a Roman hero threw himself into a chasm to save the city. It's a long story. Other stories said there was like a lightning bolt that hit it here. People just don't know what the true story is. And so there we go. There's some important parts of the Roman forum. I hope you enjoyed it. Valete omnes, lingua latina est vita.